Hi friends, welcome to Simply HR. In today's session, we are going to look at what are the uses of job description and with the help of job description, what other functions of HR are made easier. That is what is the context of today's session. In the list, it has been given performance management, training and development, compensation, recognition and rewards, discipline and return to work programs. So these are the major areas where job description as such is going to help us, help an HR professional. First of all, how job description helps in performance management. So when we talk about performance management, it is the management of performance at various levels of employees with reference to whatever skills required, whatever knowledge required, whatever attitude or abilities required. And we are checking on what we expected and what we got. On the one hand, what we expected is defined by job description. On the other hand, what we got is defined by the real outcomes of the employee's performance. So what we wanted is already given as job description, and that is what is the basis of their performance. So based on those expected terms, they are expected to perform in the real time. At the same time, on the other hand, when we have the real time performance results or outcomes of any every employee's performance, end of the appraisal period, what we are checking on what is the real time performance is checked on what was expected as JD. So in short, JD is what is the basis of performance management. So with respect to JD, we have already clearly defined out what are their tasks, what are their duties and what are their responsibilities, and at which working condition they are expected to exhibit all these tasks, duties and responsibilities. So end of the performance period, appraisal period, we will have to check these two only. So at this juncture, if we are able to check and weigh them at the expected level of task, duty, responsibilities, we are able to do the performance management with effective results. That is the way job description helps us to do performance management. At the same time, when we are talking about managing performance for the future plan period, whatever the expected level and whatever is the reality in terms of employees' performance, in these comparisons, if we get some employees performing over and above the expected level, there their plan for further growth and development is decided. So in order to take certain promotional decisions, in order to take certain transfer decisions, in order to take certain compatibility decisions also, this performance management with reference to job descriptions basis helps us. Next function which is connected to job description or job description uses for one another function of job HR function is training and development. So on the basis of same thought, on one hand we are having the expected standards of performance, on the other hand we are having the real-time performance of an employee. So when we compare at the end of the appraisal period, when we compare what is expected, what is got, these two, then we will naturally get to know whether the expected is achieved or not. If not, there comes a question, why the employee could not achieve the target expected? Why the employee could not deliver the expected result? Why the employee could not show the expected behavioral outcome? So to all these questions, one answer would be there may be lack of training. So at the capacity what the employee works now requires more training than what he has already. That is where in order to decide on certain training need analysis, also job description helps us. Next level in HR function, with reference to compensation, job description helps. How in order to compensate employees, job description helps? That's the next question. Yes. When we have the expected performance on the one hand and the real performance on the other hand, we are comparing them and coming to know whether they are at the expectation or above expectation or below our expectation. So when we found that the employee's performance is above our expectation, naturally that extra effort should be compensated accordingly. So in order to decide on the very basic compensations for every employee, the job description helps in such a way. And at the same time, when the performance in reality is over and above expectation or over and above what we expected as job description, there the extra effort also should be recognized or acknowledged duly. In that case also, a revision or an extra remuneration or some sort of acknowledgements for their extra efforts by monetary benefits or schemes, we use job description. At the same time, when they didn't reach the expected level of performance, let us assume if an employee is below our expectation, there naturally, if we have policies to reduce the compensation or we have policies not to give increment or incentive, then also our decision is justified as they were below the expectation comparing to job description. So that is where in terms of compensation decision also job description helps us. Then in terms of recognition and rewards, with same reference to compensation, whatever is due to them is compensation. At the same time, for the extra effort, for the extra targets achieved, or for the expected over and above our expected level of attitudinal change or attitudinal improvement, or the abilities that they show over and above their capacity, all these require some recognitions and rewards. So in order to have a very good appreciable recognition programs and reward programs also, job description helps us. Then comes discipline. Discipline as a function of HR. The employee's discipline also is based out of job description, because in terms of discipline, what we are supposed to do is to see whether they are in line of performance or not, or they are violating in terms of their day-to-day affairs. That is where the job description delineates the level at which they are supposed to perform. At the same time, if they go violating the route that we have given through job description, there is an action required to be taken. That action can be, if it is a negative action, that will be mostly a disciplinary action. So in order to discipline employees also, what is expected is very clearly given to them as job description. Then the last or the very important impactful, significant impact of job description in HR function with reference to return to work is, if an employee leaves us on any change of their job, maybe he is transferred to a different locality, or he is given an international assignment wherein he is not going to be in country itself for some time, or he is given a sabbatical, or he or she is given some long duration leaves. After all this, when they come back to resume the same work before which they got these changes, we will have to weigh them for what they are now. So for those kind of decisions also, job description helps us. Because before such kind of exposure to other deputed works, they are supposed to have certain level of JD. At the same time, on deputation or after an extra exposure, they should have got their task, duty, responsibilities level increased. So there also return to work program helps us with reference to transfer, promotional opportunities out of the actual workplace. All this return to work works as a positive strategy. At the same time, when people go on continuous leave or some due to some health problem, they took some medical leave or health related gap in the service. If in these conditions, if an employee to be apprised for further employment, there also this job description helps us to decide whether they should be resumed or reinstated in the same capacity from where they availed leave and went off, or their capacity should be reduced. For example, if an employee met with an accident somewhere, not necessarily in the work spot, somewhere else, he had messed with an accident and lost some capacities. By that way, we are giving him medical leave, all that are possible by laws, but at the same time, when he is reinstated, whether he can be reinstated in the same capacity, that's a big question, isn't it? So in that condition, he should also be taken into consideration. He should also be taken into our confidentiality to ensure whether he is capable of doing the old work, old level of job, or he should be reinstated in a different level of job or different level of designation. So to decide on those areas also, job description helps us. That's how return to work programs are generally carried out, both for positive outcomes or negative outcomes, using job description. With this, let me close this session. Let us deep dive into the next topic in the next session. Thank you. Bye.